What's up, guys? Back with a new video. Gonna be trying something new because I know I was talking to you guys the other day about doing some toy reviews, showcase, kind of like that. So we're gonna try that out and see if you guys like that. So I bought the Legend series for Thor Ragnarok. Bought all six of them. So I'm gonna show you guys what the boxes look like, what they look like, what they come with, and then we will show you them out of the package and the buildable figure and all that stuff. So first up, we got Ares. It comes with quite a few accessories. I know there's a little bit of glare. It's because of the window. You got his hammer. Or that's Thor's hammer, actually. I don't know why I was thinking that. So that's the part he comes with. I can't talk right now. Hulk's hammer. The Build-A-Figure is Hulk. So we got that one. Next, we got Jane Foster Thor, the female Thor. There, you got the hammer. Up there. Loki from the Thor Ragnarok picture. I'm trying to do this where you guys can see it without the glare. So there's that one. Let's see. Next we got the Thor. The Thor Ragnarok movie comes with both swords and his helmet. I think the helmet comes off. I'm not too sure though. And then the last two are Hela. His axe. So that's all six of the figures. So next I'll cut to where I got them all out of the box. You can guys see what that looks like. So I'll be back in just a second. Alright, and I'm back. I got them all unboxed. Kind of a pain to unbox all these at once. But we'll start off with Loki. Here he is. The helmet does come off. He doesn't stand too well. I'm having trouble getting him to stand up, but definitely looks pretty cool. Got a good resemblance of Tom Hiddleston. It won't focus on him, will it? No. To get out of the picture, what? Maybe? Not really, but there's that one. Next we got Hela. Which I thought I broke it because these pieces came off when I took it out of the box, but that's just, they come off to make it easier. So there she is, and both heads. There's the other one, which won't focus. What's the deal with that? So we got them two. Next we got female Thor with the hammer. I don't know, does her helmet? No, her helmet does not come off. Sorry for the blurriness, guys. My camera's not wanting to focus. One thing I figured out about these that kind of suck is their capes don't want to stay on very well, but it's okay. Next we got Thor Ragnarok Thor with both swords, and his helmet also does not come off, but looks pretty good. But see, his cape keeps falling off, which is a pain, but once they're in place, it won't really matter. Then the last one, which is probably one of the coolest looking ones out of the normal set, is Ares. He is massive. Look at the size comparison between him and Thor's. Thor's hammer is falling off. Not hammer, his cape fell off a little bit. And he also came with these two weapons, this one and that one, and he's got a dagger right here that actually comes out. So that's pretty cool. And his helmet also comes off. But that's Ares. So that's the entire set. But really the only reason I bought this set, I think the main reason only when anyone would buy this set, is for the Build-A-Figure, which is Thor Ragnarok Hulk. So we got him here, and he is massive. Look at that. Like, it's amazing. It's kind of hard to snap some of the pieces in. But almost all this armor comes off. His helmet comes off. He comes with this sword, this hammer. I don't know what that's supposed to be, really. And a smaller one that looks kind of like an axe. I forgot one. Sorry, I had him in the four. I forgot we had Odinson. Or Unworthy Thor with his axe. Got like a damaged cape. Looks pretty cool. Also, I didn't mention Loki does not come with any accessories besides the helmet. No weapons or anything. But anyways, back to this. So there he is. Everything comes off, like I said, for the most part. Except for like these and these pieces. But the helmet comes off, shoulder pad, and the little skirt looking thing. pretty amazing. They did a lot of really good work with the detail you can't see in the video, but he's actually they painted on chest hair, and like I said, you can't see in the video because also you can see the resemblance of Markruplo in it. So that's it, guys. Hopefully, I gotta figure out where I'm gonna put these at. You guys might see them in the background at some point. I'm gonna have to move some of those out of the way for these to go. But that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. They're definitely, like I said, some of them I don't like. Like Loki, I don't like that much. And Hela, I'm not a big fan of. So it sucks that you had to buy all these, but I think, in my opinion, it's worth it for the Hulk. Because he just looks amazing. Really good detail. So is it worth, how much the entire set is? I mean, it's really up to you guys. If you, some of these sets, they don't have as many characters. Like, there's a lot of these sets I buy that only have one or two characters I want. But this one's probably one that has a decent amount of good characters, might make it worth a little bit more worth the money. But yeah, so let me know if you guys want to see some more of these videos of me showcasing and reviewing different action figures, Transformers, stuff like that. That's me, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit that like button. I'd really appreciate it. I'll see you guys later.